Then let me check first. टेल मी बेटा विच वन इज करेक्ट. Tell me, beta. In question number two, here we have which one is correct? Do you think which one is the correct image?
The third one.
Third one. Okay. Why third one? Asila, you also tell me, please. Or the ये किसने बताया? Asila ने बताया. और तनिष्का ओके असीला बेटा आर यू देयर इन द क्लास
यस सर
लेट मी चेक नाउ दिस विल एक्चुअली ये हम लोग इसलिए कर रहे हैं ताकि हम लोग को पता चल जाए कि आप कहां पर आपसे कितना क्वेश्चन आता है कितना नहीं आता है सो लेट मी चेक फॉर वन और टू क्वेश्चंस एंड इफ आई थिंक दैट इज इट इनकरेक्ट देन आई विल टीच यू दिस पोर्शन अगेन ओके सो Here we have, you are saying, this is, Tanishka is saying, the option is third. Okay. Your option? Asila?
Yes, sir.
Your option in question number two, which one is correct?
1 minute, sir.
Option what?
Option C.
Option C. Okay. Tanishka, tell me the answer of question number four. Or both of you, please tell me the answer question number four. Question number four. Here, let me zoom in this one. Sorry. This one is question number four on your screen. So tell me which one is correct. Which one is the correct?
Sir, either it's A or B, I guess.
Means you have the problems in this one, okay. So, in the previous class, I was teaching you in science, I was teaching you actually the refractive index, okay. Okay, tell me, so you don't know this concept, so why should I? Asks you so let me teach you this topic first okay then I will ask you the same questions again okay let me teach you first okay so in the refraction topic actually we were studying about the Okay. So actually we were studying in the previous class, we were studying about the refraction. Okay, so let me explain you first here. So if I'm talking about a glass here, okay, and if a light is passing through a medium, okay, so here you need to understand here one thing, that if a light ray is passing through one medium to another medium, the refraction is going to occur. What do you mean by the terms refraction? Refraction simply means, number one, it simply means that the light is passing from one medium to another. Okay, and the second point is it should bend away from normal or towards normal. Okay, so when a light is passing, okay, so here we have one thing here. If a light is passing from one medium to another medium, okay, if I'm assuming that this one is the rarer medium, let's assume that this one is the air, and actually this one is the glass. So if the light is passing from rarer medium to the denser medium, so if I draw a normal line to it, normal is that line segment that is perpendicular to the surface of incident ray, means jis surface par light incident kar rahi hai us surface ke perpendicular agar koi imaginary line hai usko hum log normal bolte hain. So this is a normal line. Okay, now if this light ray is coming, so it will be passing like this way. It should be passing like this way. If it does not bend, it should be passing like this way to its original path. But instead of passing like this, it bends towards the normal. So when a light is passing from one medium to another medium, so it bends towards the normal. So if I'm considering this one is I, angle of incidence is always measured from the normal, not from this. Agar yahan se likha hua hai to aap galat hai, yahan se angle of incidence ko measure nahi karte. We always measure the angle of incidence from normal line. Okay, and actually the line is passing on this path, but actually we see that line is passing the light bends towards the normal. It bends towards the normal. Okay, and then it comes out. So here for this one, it is actually the denser medium, glass. Okay, and now again it will comes to the air. Here we have air. So this is air. Again, this is air, and this one is again a rarer medium. So when the light is passing from denser to the rarer medium, it will always bend away from the normal. And if the first medium, okay, and the second medium, and that this is the first medium, this is the second, and this is the third. If the first and third medium is same, okay, or we can say that if the light is coming out from this one, so in that case, beta, you need to understand here one thing more importantly. So here again, we can have the normal. The light should come. Light kis raaste par aani chahiye thi? The light should come to this way. If the light is coming on this way, so it should be coming like this way. It should be coming without bending. But what does light do? Light, that it bends away from the normal. Here it bends away from the normal. Okay, and you need to keep in mind here is that this line of incidence and this line of this is called the emergent line or emergent ray. They should be parallel to each other. That means whatever the angle of incidence we have, and whatever the angle of emergence we have here, it should be equal. Means angle of emergence should be equal to angle of incidence. First of all, we need to understand here. okay. Okay, means angle of emergence. We can write here angle of incidence, angle of incidence should be equal to angle of emergence. Angle of emergence. Okay, angle of incidence is equals to angle of emergence. More importantly, when the light is traveling from rarer to denser medium, it bend towards normal. And when the light is passing from denser medium to rarer medium, it bends away from the normal, from denser to rarer medium. Okay, so light is moving from rarer to denser medium, it bends towards normal. If the light is passing from denser medium to rarer medium, it will bends away from the normal. Okay, rarer medium क्या होता है? Radium medium, हमारे पास जो mediums होते हैं, हम लोग density wise देखते हैं. If we see this according to the density, we saw that air is the dense, means the mass density of the air is very low. Okay, and the mass density of glass is high as compared to air. So we generally, in general terms, we see that कि जो जिसकी डेंसिटी कम होती है वो रेयरर मीडियम होता है, जिसकी डेंसिटी ज्यादा होती है वो हम बोलेंगे कि वो डेंसर मीडियम होता है. बट इट इज नॉट 100% ट्रू. देयर आर सच अदर मीडियम आल्सो इन विच वी सी दैट इन केस ऑफ टर्पेंटाइन, इफ वी हैव दिस वन. ओके, इफ आई एम जस्ट मेकिंग हियर, you normally see that the water, this is water, okay. So we know that when we keep the water here, mixture of water and turpentine means kerosene, you can say. Okay, so if I'm taking this one as kerosene and I'm taking this one as kerosene, this one is kerosene, or you can call it turpentine. Okay, so we see that in case of this one, the density of water is more, means density means mass by volume is density. The mass by volume ratio of water is more than as compared to turpentine. But in general case, when we pass a ray of light from turpentine to water, okay, we see that light, instead of bending towards the normal, because it is the rarer medium, the mass density of turpentine is less than water. Mass density means mass by volume. But there are two types of density. One is the mass density, another one is the optical density. But when we pass the light, experimentally we observe from when we pass the light from turpentine to water, instead of bending towards the normal, it bends away from the normal. Okay. It bends away from the normal. So if I draw the normal line here, so instead of coming to this one, it bends away from the normal. Ye normal se us taraf bend ho gayi. Bends away from the normal. So we can simply say that in this case, if the light is moving away from the normal, so we will see that this water is optically rarer medium here, and here turpentine Turpentine is optically denser. Turpentine is optically denser medium. Got it, beta? Got it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So it is not necessary that every time when we are having the mass density of something, okay, so it is not necessary that the mass, if the mass density is more, then we will simply say that if the mass density is more, then it will be optically denser. No, it is not necessary. Turpentine is we will say that turpentine and water may, अगर हम लोग देखते हैं तो मास डेंसिटी ऑफ वाटर इज मोर एज कंपैरिजन टू टर्पेंटाइन, बट वी सी दैट टर्पेंटाइन इज ऑप्टिकली डेंसर देन द वाटर. ओके, सो कमिंग टू दिस वन, नाउ यू हैव टू आंसर मी दिस क्वेश्चन. दिस वन इज द सेम, देन यू हैव टू आंसर मी दिस क्वेश्चन. विच वन इज करेक्ट इन द क्वेश्चन नंबर वन, विच वन इज करेक्ट? राइट, इफ यू अगेन टेल मी that it is incorrect, then I will answer you. Okay. Tell me, beta, which one is correct? Okay, let me help you. Here in this question, you see that. What do you see actually? Let me bring this question to the next portion. Okay, wait a minute. So here in this question, what you see actually, okay, so okay, you see beta, इस question में आप देखेंगे क्या देखेंगे? You will see here that the light here is traveling from rare to denser medium, then it bends towards the normal, so this was correct. But here when it is passing from air to this one, it is slightly moving away from the normal, it is correct. But here when it is coming from this one, this region, it is not deviating, it is just passing straight without bending. So this one is incorrect. So we can simply say that this ray and this ray, okay, but they are not showing any deviation here, so this will be considered as incorrect, because water is a denser medium, and this one is the rarer medium. So when the light is passing from water to air, so it should bend away from the normal, okay, but it is not bending. Here you see that when the light is traveling from the air to oil, again it is passing straight, it is not bending towards the normal, it should bend towards the normal. Why it should bend towards the normal? Because as comparison to air, oil is denser, air is the rarer medium. So we simply say that it should bend away towards the normal, but here it is not bending, so this one is incorrect. Here you see that in the C portion, that light is passing through this one, debiting. Moreover, it is passing through this one. And here you see that this ray, it should bend when it is passing from the water. Instead of passing, it is bending away from the normal. So here C option is the correct option. See the correct. Why D is incorrect? D is incorrect because when the light is traveling from water to actually air, here the light is bending towards the normal. But it should bend away from the normal. So here we can see that only C is the correct option for this one. Got it, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Similarly, please tell me the option, correct option for this question, for this one and this one. Now, will you be able to tell me the answer of question number two? Question number two, which one is the correct option? Light is passing from air to glass here in this question, and we have this one. Which one do you think is the correct option?
So we said third part.
You said third part. Okay. And yes, Asila, do you have any answer?
Third part only, sir.
Third part. Okay. Let me check why the first part is incorrect. First part is incorrect because if you see this one, the light is coming. And then you see that this one is for giving a straight line. Actually, it is giving a straight line here to this one. So light should not bend when a light is coming and having some angle of incidence. Okay. And here for some angle of incidence, there must be some angle of refraction. And we always measure the angle with the normal. You know that we always measure the angle with the normal. Hum log normal se measure karte hain. Okay. So if you think that this is the normal line, okay, there is an incident ray coming and it is entering the glass slab. So if I'm having some angle of incidence, value of sine I, okay, so it should bend towards the normal, but it should not bend such much that it comes along the normal line. Only the light can comes along the normal line. Along the normal line, when it is passing along the normal, means if the angle of incidence is zero, then only the light can come this one. Or main bata dun aapko ki hum log angle of incidence zero kab keh rahe hain, jab normal, because hum log normal se measure karte hain. This is the normal. If I'm having some angle here, this suppose this is 30. If I bring this, this is the normal line. If I bring it like this way, then let's suppose it is 20. And if I make it more closer to this one, it will become zero. In the similar way, if I'm saying that this one is angle is 20. So if I bring this one to this one, how much I can bring this one? The maximum I can bring this one to this, it can come over, it can overlap to this one. So here the light is actually overlapping the normal. So the angle of refraction here is 0 degree. And if I'm saying that for some sine angle of incidence upon sine angle of refraction, if we have the refractive index something. So if I'm saying here that the angle of incidence here, or we can say that angle R is equals to we have some angle of incidence. So there must be some angle of refractions here. Means kuch na kuch angle of refraction hamare paas hona zaruri hai. Got it? Otherwise it is not possible. Why it is not possible? Let me explain you. Kyun aisa hona zaruri hai? कि साइन की कोई ना कोई वैल्यू होनी चाहिए. अगर हमारे पास कोई ना कोई एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस है तो हमारे पास रिफ्रैक्शन की मतलब कोई ना कोई रिफ्रैक्शन एंगल जरूर होना चाहिए. सो लेट सपोज इफ आई एम सेइंग दैट दिस इज साइन 30, ओके, द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन 30 इज 0.5, ओके, द ओके मैक्सिममली आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग यू द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन 0 इज 0 एंड साइन 90 इज 1. और साइन की मैक्सिमम वैल्यू जो है वो 0 से 90 के बीच में 0 से 1 के बीच में लाई कर सकती है. मींस अ वैल्यू ऑफ साइन द मैक्सिमम वैल्यू ऑफ साइन फ्रॉम 0 टू 90 डिग्री लाइज बिटवीन 0 टू 1. यानी 0 साइन 0 से लेकर के साइन 90 तक साइन की मैक्सिमम वैल्यू 0 साइन 0 और 90 पर मैक्सिमम होती है. मतलब इसके बीच में ही लाई करेगी सारी वैल्यूज, इसके बाहर और यहां पर कोई वैल्यूज नहीं होती. एंड वी नो दैट द एब्सोल्यूट रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स मींस द रेशियो ऑफ एयर टू, इफ द लाइट इज ट्रैवलिंग फ्रॉम एयर टू समथिंग, इट शुड बी ऑलवेज ग्रेटर देन 1. कुछ भी हम लोग ले रहे हैं, ग्लास ले लेते हैं, ग्लास का जो रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स होता है वो 1.5 होता है. सो इट शुड बी ऑलवेज ग्रेटर देन 1. वो 1 से ज्यादा होना चाहिए. और अगर वो 1 से ज्यादा है, मींस इफ आई एम सेइंग दैट दिस वन शुड बी ग्रेटर देन 1, and the maximum value of sine can be 1. So if I'm saying here, if I'm saying that sine 0 is 0, if I'm making here the angle of refraction is 0. So if I'm saying that sine I upon sine r, and r if I'm considering here, sine r is 0, means if I'm dividing, if whatever the value if I'm having, if there is 0, it can have the infinite refractive index, which is not possible. Which is not possible. It can only be possible when 0 upon 0 is there. Then it will be 0. Means if we have sine 0, then r will be automatically 0. If we have I 0, then I will. And how it is possible? Then if we have I 0, when the light is passing, when light is passing along the normal, means making with 0 degree with the normal, because we always measure the angle with the normal. Hum log normal se angle measure karte hain. Aur agar light normal hi ja rahi hai, normal ke along ja rahi hai, to phir angle kitna hoga? 0. The angle will be 0. So here we will have this one. This one is 0. Is angle. So here there will be no angle of refraction. There will be no angle of incidence. Or we can, angle of incidence is 0, angle of refraction is 0. So here actually the angle of refraction is 0. Here the angle of refraction is 0. Got it, beta?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so okay, now consider, now tell me why the option second is incorrect. Second is incorrect because you are choosing the option number third. Then why are you saying that the option number two is incorrect? Tell me. Tell me, beta, why you consider that the option second is incorrect? Option second is incorrect. Why? Because let me explain you why it is incorrect. If you see that this light is coming to this path, okay, we are saying that the emergent ray and they are parallel. The incident ray and the emergent ray are parallel to each other. So they are parallel. So this is, but what is happening here is that if I pass this light to this one, if I pass this light along this one, okay, so let the light is passing through this angle, okay, and if I draw the normal, if I draw the normal to this line, okay, and if light is passing through this one, so you see that actually the light is bending away from the normal. Instead of bending towards the normal, it is bending away from the normal. So here you see that the light is, okay. So you have to see that the light is bending away from the normal, which is not possible because this is the denser medium. This is the rarer medium. And then when the light is traveling from rare to denser, it is okay. Got it? So this one is incorrect.
Yes.
Why it is incorrect? It is incorrect because here we see that the incident ray and the emergent ray are not parallel. It should be parallel to each other. So this one is also incorrect. Then the correct option will be only D is possible. Okay. Okay. Now tell me the in option number four, which one is correct? बेटर टेल मी, इसमें तो आप सोचिए कि मैंने अभी तो बताया था आप लोग को, विच वन इज करेक्ट?
डी पार्ट
डी पार्ट. असीला डू यू हैव एनी आंसर बेटा?
बी
पार्ट. द करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ए. We don't measure the angle of incidence with the surface. Here in all of them, we are measuring the angle of incidence with this surface. This is not correct. This is not correct. This is not correct. Only the option will be C. 1. Okay.
Okay.
So that's we learn about this one. Okay. So let's move to the next topic, or means the topic is same actually. Let's understood this one. Okay. In thoroughly in great detail. Okay. So let's move. Now our next topic is we have done this one regarding to the refraction. Now let me go through this one. Okay. So let's talk about this one. Will you be able to solve this question? Will you be able to solve this question? Which one is? Okay, let me explain you the refractive index. Today we will going to complete the refractive index topic, and then we shall be proceeding further. Okay, so let's talk. What actually the refractive index is? Refractive index is actually refractive index is actually, we simply say that refractive index is actually sine I upon sine r. It is also equals to the speed of light in medium one to speed of light in medium two, and it is also equals to real depth upon apparent depth. Real depth upon apparent depth. Okay, now you need to concentrate here. The refractive index, since we have the speed of light here, meter per second upon meter per second, so this will cancel out. So refractive index do not have, it is a unitless, or we can say the dimensionless quantity. Okay, moreover, what you need to understood here is, let me explain you what we need to understood and concentrate here is, okay, let me talk about it. So first of all, you need to understood here that the refractive index is equals to sine upon sine r. Okay, this portion you have studied. Now let's talk about these two portions, the speed of light in medium one to the speed of light in medium two. Okay, when the light is traveling from one medium to another medium, actually its speed decreases or increases. If the light is passing from rarer to denser medium, actually its speed decreases. And it, okay, if the light is traveling from rarer to denser medium, actually its speed decreases. Okay, or you can simply say that if we need to calculate the refractive index, the ratio of the speed of light to the speed of medium, so we can have the speed of light in first medium upon speed of light in second medium. Okay, you need to concentrate here that we have the two types of refractive index. One is the absolute refractive index, refractive index is actually of two types. We have two types of refractive index. One is the absolute refractive index. Another one is the relative refractive index. Another one is the relative refractive index that I have also taught you before in the previous classes. Absolute refractive index का मतलब होता है कि absolute मतलब हम लोगों ने पहला जो medium है वो air या vacuum को select किया है, कि light जो है वो air से किसी भी दूसरे medium में जा रही है, हमें मतलब नहीं है वो दूसरा medium क्या है, लेकिन पहला मीडियम हमारा एयर या वैक्यूम होगा. हियर द फर्स्ट मीडियम इज एयर और वैक्यूम. हियर यहां पर रिलेटिव रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स में जरूरी नहीं है कि कोई भी मीडियम हो सकता है, पहला मीडियम कोई भी हो सकता है एयर को छोड़ करके, तो वो रिलेटिव रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स होगा. सो इफ आई एम कंपैरिजिंग हियर दैट इफ द लाइट इज ट्रैवलिंग फ्रॉम वाटर टू ग्लास इट इज अ रिलेटिव रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स. इफ द लाइट इज ट्रैवलिंग फ्रॉम ग्लास टू एयर इट इज अ रिलेटिव रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स. इफ अ लाइट इज ट्रैवलिंग फ्रॉम वाटर टू डायमंड इट इज अ रिलेटिव रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स. And absolute refractive index is if the light is traveling from air to glass, if the light is traveling from air to water, if the light is traveling from air to diamond, if the light is traveling from air to turpentine, it can be. The first medium should be air. Here we don't have the first medium air. We can have the second if we instead of having means it is compulsory है कि हमारे पास पहला medium air नहीं होना चाहिए. दूसरा मीडियम एयर हो सकता है तभी भी वो रिलेटिव रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ही माना जाएगा. ओके बेटा गॉट इट? और स्टिल हैविंग सम डाउट रिगार्डिंग टू दिस स्टेटमेंट? यू अंडरस्टैंड?
यस सर.
ओके नाउ आई एम जस्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट एब्सोल्यूट रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स की अगर हम बात करते हैं. सो वी हैव एयर टू ग्लास लेट्स सपोज इट मींस दैट स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इन एयर upon speed of light in glass. Now tell me, in which medium do you think the speed of light is more, air or glass? Tell me, kis medium mein is
air?
Air. Yes, the speed of light in air is more. Means we are going to have the numerator, और हम लोग बोल सकते हैं कि वैक्यूम के अलावा हर जगह पर एयर में स्पीड ऑफ लाइट ज्यादा होती है, या हम लोग इसको एयर या वैक्यूम भी बोल सकते हैं. दिस इज वैक्यूम. सो इफ आई एम जस्ट कंसीडरिंग हियर दैट वी आर जस्ट डिवाइडिंग द न्यूमीटर दैट इज द हाईएस्ट पॉसिबल विद समथिंग दैट इज लेसर, सो वी विल बी गोइंग टू हैव ऑलवेज द वैल्यू दैट शुड बी ग्रेटर देन वन. मतलब अगर मैं बात करूं तो हमारे पास कौन सी वैल्यूज होंगी, दैट शुड बी ऑलवेज ग्रेटर देन वन. ओके दैट शुड बी ग्रेटर देन वन. तो हमारे पास ऐसी वैल्यूज होनी चाहिए जो ग्रेटर देन वन होंगी. ओके मतलब अगर मैं बात करूं तो न्यूमीटर हमारे पास बड़ा है, दैट इज 3 × 10⁸ मीटर पर सेकेंड. अगर मैं बोल रहा हूँ कि हमारे पास दूसरा मीडियम है जिसकी बात करें, अगर हम लोग 2.90 भी बोल रहे हैं हम लोग किसी एक मीडियम में, तो तभी भी हमारे पास जो आंसर आएगा वो 1 से ज्यादा आएगा. सो वी कैन सिंपली से दैट द एब्सोल्यूट रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स इज ग्रेटर देन वन. ठीक है, ग्रेटर देन वन हो सकता है. ओके वन से कम कब होगा? वन से कम पॉसिबल नहीं है, बट द रिलेटिव रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स कैन बी ग्रेटर देन वन और लेस देन वन. क्योंकि हम लोग को नहीं पता कि किस मीडियम में, जो हमने ऊपर वाला मीडियम रखा है उसमें स्पीड ऑफ लाइट ज्यादा है कि कम है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई एम सेइंग दैट द एज कंपेयरिंग इफ आई एम कंपेयरिंग द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट ऑफ स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इन वाटर to the speed of light in glass. Okay, so here we can write it like this way. So we can write it like this way that the speed of light in water to the speed of light in glass. Okay, so here we will going to have this, we know that the speed of light in water is more as comparison to the speed of light in glass. Okay, चलो ये भी नहीं पता होगा तुम्हें, तो हम लोग बात करते हैं. तो हम लोगों ने एक काम किया. क्या काम किया बेटा, ध्यान समझना. हम लोगों ने हर एक मीडियम को लिया, ग्लास को लिया, वाटर को लिया, डायमंड को लिया, टर्पेंटाइन मतलब जितने भी हैं, और हमने सबकी एक टेबल बना दी. एब्सोल्यूट रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स की टेबल बना दी हम लोगों ने. जब भी हम लोग को दिया होगा कि द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ ग्लास इज दिस वन, द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ वाटर इज दिस वन, द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ डायमंड इज दिस वन, इट मींस दैट द वी आर जस्ट कंपेयरिंग द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इन एयर टू द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इन ग्लास. मींस हमारा जो पहला मीडियम है वो एयर है और हम लोगों ने दूसरे मीडियम में ग्लास में लाइट पास की है. सो हम लोग ने एक टेबल बना दी कि द एब्सोल्यूट रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ एयर टू ग्लास इज 1.5, the absolute refractive index of air to diamond is 2.42, the absolute refractive index of water is 1.33. so is tarah se hum logo ne ek table bana di aur hamare paas jo table hoti hai usi mein hum log beta isko bolte hain these are the absolute refractive index, but we cannot have the table of relative refractive index kyunki hame pata hi nahi hai kaun se medium ka ratio kiske sath hai, hum log ko nahi pata. बट वी कैन कैलकुलेट, हम लोग कैलकुलेट कर सकते हैं कि भाई रिलेटिव रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स क्या होगा, रिलेटिव रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स वाटर टू ग्लास का क्या होगा, ग्लास टू एयर का क्या होगा, एयर टू डायमंड का क्या होगा, वाटर टू डायमंड का क्या होगा. लेट्स कैलकुलेट दिस वन, लेट्स कैलकुलेट. समझते हैं, पहले समझने की कोशिश करते हैं और इसी चीज को हम लोग को आज समझना है. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, सो लेट्स अंडरस्टूड दिस वन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी हैव द टेबल दैट द एयर टू ग्लास रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स इज एक्चुअली that is 1.5 or you can write it 3/2. The absolute refractive index of air to water is 1.33. So if I need to calculate the relative refractive index, means the ratio when the light is traveling from glass to water, okay, what should be the ratio, means we don't know the speed of light in glass, okay, we hame nahi pata, lekin hum log calculate karna chahte hain. Hum log ko question mein given hai ki aapko absolute refractive index ग्लास का और डायमंड का इतना होता है, यानी कि जब लाइट एयर से ग्लास में जाएगी तब इतना होगा और जब लाइट एयर से वाटर में जाएगी तब इतना होगा. बेटा समझ में आ रहा है आप लोग को?
यस सर.
श्योर? ओके ओके. सो अभी हम लोग को पता करना है, तो वी नीड टू कैलकुलेट दिस वन. ओके, हाउ कैन वी कैलकुलेट बेटा? सो दिस इज वेरी सिंपल, हाउ कैन वी कैलकुलेट. सो लेट्स, सो वी नो दैट आई हैव टॉट यू दिस वन, दैट कि अगर हम लोग को ग्लास टू निकालना है, हम लोग को दो एब्सोल्यूट रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स गिवन है. सो राइट ग्लास हेयर, राइट वाटर हेयर, एंड देयर कॉमन मीन्स एयर, दिस इज राइट हेयर एंड राइट हेयर. नाउ यू नो दैट मीन्स इट इज नॉट गिवन टू अस दैट द एब्सोल्यूट रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ मीन्स वी हैव बीन गिवन दैट द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ एयर टू ग्लास इज 3/2. सो एक्चुअली वी हैव टू राइट हेयर फ्रॉम व्हेन द लाइट इज ट्रैवलिंग फ्रॉम ग्लास टू एयर. सो हाउ कैन वी राइट इट? The light is, it is being given that the air to glass is 3/2, then the refractive index from glass to air will be reciprocal of this one. Reciprocal of this one means it will become, this will become like this one, this will become 2/3. So you have to write here 2/3 into air to water, it is being given that is 4/3. So you have to write here beta 4/3. Now you can write it 8/9. Got it? 8/9 is the correct option. Got it?
Yes.
So here we can calculate. हम लोग calculate कर सकते हैं. अगर हम लोग को given है कि diamond का refractive index इतना है, उसका इतना है. So if I am saying you कि आप मुझे calculate करके बताइए कि अगर, चलो अभी हम लोग करेंगे इस question को भी. Okay. So I'm talking about this. Okay. Moreover, what we need to understand here is that कि जब light, when the light is traveling from denser to rarer medium, actually rarer medium to denser medium, rarer to denser medium. Okay, so actually its speed decreases. This one is the denser medium, and this one is the rarer medium. Okay, so if I'm talking about this one, so when the light is traveling from rarer to denser medium, if the light is traveling from rarer to denser medium, its speed decreases. Uski jo speed hai na beta, wo kya karti hai? डिक्रीज करती है. जब रेयर से डेंसर मीडियम में जाती है तो उसकी स्पीड क्या करती है? डिक्रीज करती है. मोर द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स, मोर लेस विल बी द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इन दैट मीडियम. सो अगर मैं बात करता हूं कि आपको एब्सोल्यूट रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ग्लास का आपको दैट इज बीन गिवन दैट इज 1.5 एंड दैट ऑफ वाटर इज 1.33, आप मुझे बताइए कि लाइट अगर, अच्छा अभी मैं पहले पूरा समझा देता हूँ कि द स्पीड ऑफ, अगर लाइट जो है, इफ द लाइट इज मूविंग फ्रॉम रेयरर टू डेंसर मीडियम देन इट्स स्पीड डिक्रीजेस, स्पीड डिक्रीज होगी एंड इट विल बेंड टूवर्ड्स नॉर्मल, टूवर्ड्स नॉर्मल, वो नॉर्मल की तरफ बेंड करेगी। या फिर आप ऐसे समझ सकते हैं बेटा, एक सिंपल सा क्वेश्चन आपसे मैं पूछता हूँ, इफ यू थिंक दैट यू आर मूविंग ऑन अ हाईवे रोड एंड सडनली योर कार हैव सम प्रॉब्लम देन व्हाट विल यू डू, मींस यू थिंक दैट योर कार इज नॉट वर्किंग प्रॉपरली, तो व्हाट विल यू डू, विल यू कीप इट मूविंग, विल यू कीप इट मूविंग विद मोर फास्टर स्पीड और विल यू साइड इट टू द रोड एंड विल चेक व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम, क्या करोगे?
Will stop the car on the left side.
Okay. In the similar way, when the light is traveling from such a, it is moving from rarer to denser medium. And denser medium, you can see that there is denser medium. में आप समझ लीजिए कि एक ऐसी जगह है जहाँ पर बहुत गंदी रोड है और अच्छी रोड नहीं है, मतलब गाड़ी खराब हो गई है. So आप समझ लीजिए कि if the light is traveling from rarer to denser medium, then it will समझ लीजिए कि नॉर्मल जो है वो रोड है साइड एंड इट विल कम्स टूवर्ड्स द नॉर्मल, ओके, वो नॉर्मल की तरफ आ जाएगी, इट विल कम्स टूवर्ड्स द नॉर्मल मतलब साइड में आ जाएगी, तो स्पीड डिक्रीज होती है तब नॉर्मल की तरफ जाती है, स्पीड बढ़ती है तब नॉर्मल से दूर जाती है, ओके, सो दिस इज द डेंसर मीडियम हियर, सो वी कैन से दैट मोर द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स, मोर द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स more will be the less will be the speed of light, more the refractive index, less will be the speed of light. Speed of light. Okay. So let's, I'm talking about. ये मेरे पास एक medium है. You will think that it is a glass, so I'm making it different way. So मेरे पास, this is the medium first. This is the medium. Okay. If I'm saying that, you have to trace this one. This is the medium one. Okay, but I have to come for me because the water tank is full, or and I have to switch off the motor so that otherwise it will. No one is here to switch off the motor. So let me switch off this. Wait a minute. Okay. Okay, so if I'm saying that this is the medium one, this is medium two, this is medium three, and this is medium four. Now I'm just making something like this way. Now tell me beta, which one, medium one means medium one is going to have the x refractive index. Medium two is going to have to x, y, z. This one is going to have A refractive index. This one is going to have B refractive index. This one is going to have C. This one is going to have D. Arrange them in increasing order of the refractive index. Here, if I'm saying that in this case, from this one and this one, so if you think that it is not here, the light from when the light is traveling from 2 to 3, it is bending away from the normal, when the light is traveling from 2 to 3.
So can you repeat in what way we have to rearrange them?
In increasing order of the refractive index means the one which is going to have the least refractive index, you have to write it. Okay. First, and then you have to write the another one. Which one is going to have the least refractive index? You have to write it first, and then you have to write the tell me, Asila. Asila.
Yes, sir.
बेटा समझ में आया आपको?
No, sir.
नहीं समझ आया? Okay, मैं समझाता हूँ. Okay, just understood this one again. हम लोग दोबारा समझते हैं. देखो, जितना ज़्यादा normal से bend होगी light, उतना कम refractive index होगा. जितना ज्यादा बेंड करेगी नॉर्मल से अवे फ्रॉम दी नॉर्मल उतना कम रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स, बिकॉज लेस द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स मोर विल बी द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट. और सबसे कम रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स हो सकता है 1, एब्सोल्यूट रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स. या समझ लीजिए कि इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस वन, दैट हियर इफ यू सी दैट द नॉर्मल विद द नॉर्मल, दिस इज द एंगल ऑफ इमर्जेंस आप बोल सकते हैं, या दिस वन. सो हियर द लाइट इज बेंडिंग अवे फ्रॉम द नॉर्मल, एंड इट इज, let if I'm talking about this one, it is coming towards the normal. Here it is again moving away from the normal. Here it is moving away from the normal. Okay, so you see that here, if I'm talking about this one, here the 4 is going to have the highest bending away from the normal. So you will consider that 4 is going to have the least refractive index. That's why I've told you that least the refractive index, more will be the speed of light. और जितनी ज्यादा स्पीड ऑफ लाइट होगी वो नॉर्मल से उतना ही आगे होगा, जितनी कम स्पीड ऑफ लाइट होगी उतना ही नॉर्मल के करीब होगा. ओके, नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस वन, सो 4 मींस मीडियम 4 इज गोइंग टू हैव द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स, सो यू कैन राइट हियर डी इज गोइंग टू हैव द लीस्ट रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स. देन टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस वन, नाउ 2 and 3 and 1, ओके 1, नाउ यू सी दैट एज कंपैरिजन टू 1 and 2, इफ आई एम कंपैरिंग 1 and 2, 1 व्हेन द लाइट इज ट्रैवलिंग फ्रॉम मीडियम 1 टू 2, and the light is traveling from medium 1 to 2, it is bending towards the normal. इसका मतलब हुआ कि स्पीड ऑफ लाइट ए में ज्यादा है, बी में कम है, तभी तो वो टूवर्ड्स नॉर्मल गई। मैंने बताया भी है आपको कि अगर गाड़ी खराब हो जाती है तो वो आप उसको साइड में लेके आते हैं नॉर्मल की तरफ। तो इन द सिमिलर वे स्पीड ऑफ लाइट यहाँ पर डिक्रीज कर गई एंड यहाँ पर स्पीड ऑफ लाइट ज्यादा है। सो वी कैन कंसिडर दिस वन दैट इन मीडियम ए, फ्रॉम मीडियम ए टू बी, स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इन मीडियम ए इज ग्रेटर देन बी। ओके, और वी कैन से दैट इफ द मोर द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट, मोर द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट less will be the refractive index, more the speed of light less will be the refractive index. So I can say that here in a the refractive index of a is less as comparison to that of b. Okay, now we have to talk about b and c, comparison to b and c. We are seeing that when the light is traveling from b to c, okay, so it is bending away from the normal. So यहां पर आप देखते हैं कि यहां पर लाइट जो है वो अवे फ्रॉम द नॉर्मल है, लेकिन अभी भी हम लोग देखेंगे फर्स्ट मीडियम के कंपैरिजन में वो टूवर्ड्स द नॉर्मल ही है। यानी कि मैं अगर कंपेयर करता हूँ फर्स्ट में, बी में और सी में, तो आप देखोगे कि ये लाइन इस लाइन के कंपेरिजन में, दिस लाइन, इफ दिस लाइन कम्स टू दिस वन, सो दिस विल मेक द पैरेलल लाइन लाइक दिस वे, मीन्स दिस लाइन कैन बी पैरेलल. Actually, these two lines are not parallel. This line and these lines are not parallel. This line can be parallel if it is like this way. So we can simply say that कि ये इसके comparison में अभी भी ये normal की तरफ bend हुई हुई है. यानी कि हम बोलेंगे कि A में, मतलब A के comparison में C का जो refractive index है वो कम है. Sorry, C में जो speed of light है वो कम है, A में अभी भी ज्यादा है. A में अगर स्पीड ऑफ लाइट ज्यादा है तो उसका रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स कम होगा. तो हम बोलेंगे कि इस केस में भी A का रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स इज ग्रेटर देन एज कंपैरिजन टू A. ओके, सो वी कैन सिंपली से दैट A रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स इज लेस देन B. और वी कैन सिंपली से दैट दिस इज द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स की बात कर रहे हैं हम लोग. स्पीड ऑफ लाइट की अगर हम बात करेंगे तो वी कैन कंसिडर सिंपल दिस वन की अभी भी A का जो रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स है या स्पीड ऑफ लाइट जो है वो ए में ज्यादा है सी की कंपैरिजन में. ए में स्पीड ऑफ लाइट ज्यादा है. तो पहले हम लोग एक काम करते हैं, हम लोग, क्योंकि स्पीड ऑफ लाइट से ज्यादा आसानी से समझ जाओगे, आपको मैंने एग्जांपल भी दिया है कि व्हेन द लाइट इज ट्रैवलिंग अवे फ्रॉम द नॉर्मल इट इज गोइंग टू हैव द मोर स्पीड एंड इफ इट इज कमिंग टूवर्ड्स द नॉर्मल इट इज गोइंग टू हैव द लेस स्पीड. सो एक काम करते हैं हम लोग पहले स्पीड ऑफ लाइट के हिसाब से अरेंज कर लेते हैं. जिसमें सबसे ज्यादा स्पीड ऑफ लाइट होगी उसको हम लोग पहले लिखेंगे. मोर द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट वी आर राइटिंग हियर, मोर स्पीड एंड लेस स्पीड हम लोग यहाँ पर लिखेंगे. लेस स्पीड लीस्ट मतलब हम लोग यहाँ पर लिखेंगे. ओके, सो सबसे ज्यादा बेंडिंग अवे फ्रॉम द नॉर्मल इसमें है तो हम लोग लिखेंगे यहाँ पर कि फोर मीडियम में सबसे ज्यादा स्पीड ऑफ लाइट है. तो ये तो फर्स्ट हमेशा ही रहेगा. नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द फर्स्ट एंड फर्स्ट में और सेकेंड में, तो आपको पता है कि ये नॉर्मल की तरफ बेंड कर गया है. तो वी कैन सिंपली से दैट कि ए में स्पीड ऑफ लाइट ज्यादा है और बी में one medium mein speed of light is more than as comparison to medium 2. We have done this one. Now talking about this one, agar aap compare karte hain 1 ko aur 3 ko, okay, 1 ko aur 3 ko, kyunki hum log ko arrange karna hai na 1 2, ab 3 jo hai wo hum kahan par laye, 1 aur 2 ke beech mein ya iske baad, theek hai. So let's talk about, so abhi hum baat kar rahe hain ki speed of light jo hai wo abhi bhi 1 mein zyada hai. Speed of light in 1 is more because it is still away from the normal and it is bending towards the normal here. Because if we draw the parallel line to this way, agar hum log parallel line draw karte hain aise, so abhi bhi ye towards the normal hoga. Okay, so let's, WhatsApp is working though, so let me eliminate this one because it is creating a disturbance. Okay, wait a minute. Okay, so if I'm talking about 1, okay, so 1 mein abhi bhi speed of light zyada hai than 3. Now 2 and 3 mein compare karte hain. If we're comparing with 2 and 3, so we see that in 2 and 3, I have written here ki that is when the light is traveling from 2 to 3, it is moving away from the normal. Away from the normal, we can simply say that ki 3 mein speed of light zyada hai than comparison of 2. Means 3 में स्पीड ऑफ लाइट ज्यादा है एज कंपेरिजन टू 2. सो आप मुझे अरेंज करके बताइए कि आप इसको कैसे लिखेंगे. 1 2 3 लिखेंगे, या 132 लिखेंगे स्पीड ऑफ लाइट के कंपैरिजन, बताइए फटाफट से।
132
वन देन थ्री देन टू, ओके, बिकॉज वन तो हमेशा ही दोनों से ज्यादा है तो आप वन को पहले लिखेंगे, उसके बाद आप देखेंगे कि टू से पहले थ्री आएगा, देन थ्री देन थ्री देन टू। ये समझ में आया बेटा असीला, यहां तक समझ में आया?
Yes,
because one जो है we are writing one is greater than both two and three, so we have to write one, decided, final. Then we have to write which one is greater. So two in two and three, we will write that three is speed of light in three is more, because I am saying that when the light is traveling from two to three, it is bending away from the normal. So if it is bending away from the normal, means the speed of light in two three is more in two. And then we have to write here that the highest speed of light is in four. We have to write here four. So I have taught you that the speed of light, more the speed of light, less will be the refractive index. More the speed of light, less will be the refractive index. Jitna kam refractive index hoga, utni hi zyada speed of light hogi. So we can simply write here that D mein sabse kam refractive index. Then we can write here then A, then C, then B. This is the correct order for the refractive index. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, take a screenshot of this one. Take the screenshot. Done, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that's all for today. We'll meet you in the next class. तो ये अभी आपका दिल है तो मैं और पढ़ा सकता हूँ, टाइम है आपके पास, टॉपिक कंप्लीट करना था, और we shall try in the next class.
So your wish.
Hmm?
Your wish.
ये मेरी wish है. Tanishka, tell me.
Yes, sir, I said your wish.
Okay, Asila, your way. Asila, do you want to study more?
Your wish, sir.
Your wish. Okay, let's do. So, ये हमारे पास आ गया है value. So, इस तरह से हम लोग को पता चल जाएगा कि कौन सा refractive index के basis पर हम लोग इनको solve कर सकते हैं, इस तरह questions को solve कर सकते हैं. Okay, now we have talked about the refractive index. We have talked about this one, speed of light in mat. Okay, so now you can understood. Let me talk about one or Let me give you some examples and let's consider this one. These are very important examples. So let's you need to tell me the answer. Okay. So wait a minute. It's a question. Okay, wait a minute. Let me bring out the question. Okay. So if I'm writing here, 10th. Okay, so beta, let me, this one is the actually CBSE sample paper. Okay, let me show you first. And then you have to answer me the question. Okay. So if I'm talking about okay, tell me, this is the CBSE sample paper. Tell me this year 2021 and 22. So tell me the options, which one is the correct option for the question number actually in question number 20. Which one is the correct option? If it has been given the three absolute refractive index to us, 1.5, 1.0003, and then 1.33. Then tell me in which of the following we were going to have the most speed of light. Which one is the correct option, correct order? Anishka, Asina, tell me, beta. Which one is the correct option? Abhi to bataya tha ki more the refractive index, less will be the speed of light. Refractive index is the hazard that is creating disturbance to the speed of light. You can see, consider it also. आप ऐसा समझ सकते हैं कि जितना ज्यादा refractive index होगा वो मना कर रहा है कि speed of light ज्यादा नहीं होगी उसमें. So here we have glass that is 1.5, then here is this one and glass. So we can say that the more speed of light will be in air, then water, then
sir, option C.
Yes, option C is the correct. Then light, air, mein, fir uske baad water. Mein, okay, got it. Dekho, abhi jo humne padha wo CBSE ne uspe question pooch liya. So you have to keep in mind this one very carefully. Okay, let's move to the next question. Okay, tell me, this one is also a question that is being asked by CBSC. Which one is the correct option?
So D part.
D part. Okay. Okay. Asila, your answer.
Sir, D.
D part. Okay. Okay. So if I'm saying that if the light is traveling from medium one and you see that here it is bending towards the normal, it means we can simply say that one is denser as comparison to this one is rarer for this and this one is denser. If I am comparing one and two. Okay. And when the light is traveling from two to three, it is again rarer. Means it, for two, it is again rarer. But you see that here it is being given in the question that this one angle is equals to this one. And when it is possible, this is only possible when the medium first and second is same, medium first and third is same. So when the light is traveling from one medium and it bends towards the normal, okay, it should bend towards the normal, okay, and then it comes away from this one. And if this angle of incidence is equals to angle of emergence, okay, this angle and this angles are equal. So we will say that this medium and this medium will be same. So if it is saying angle one is equals to angle three, so medium one and three is same. And moreover, you are finding that here that, and 480 is also saying that four and angle four is equal, this one and this one is also same. So four is equals to four means here, and we are saying that this is not a deviation in the light. Since if there is no deviation or there is no bending of light taking place here, that means that this medium is same. Bending of light is not possible only in two cases. If the light is passing normally, okay, then there will be no bending. Or if the medium is same, means if the light is passing straight without bending, it means this medium and this medium is same. So here we can say that medium one is actually this one is medium one and this three is actually one because this one and this one is same. So we can say that medium one and three is same. Okay, so here it is medium one and three is essentially the same medium, but medium two is denser than medium one and three. Yes, medium two is denser than medium one and three. So this one is same. So this type of question, simple question that will be asked in the examinations. So that's all for today. Aaj chhod hi dete hain, then late ho jayega, fir aap log ko khana wana khayenge 10 baj chuke. ओके सो पढ़ाने का मकसद समझ में आया आपको कि हम लोगों ने जो पढ़ा उस पे क्वेश्चंस कैसे आएंगे आपको एग्जाम में. सीला एंड तनिष्का.
Yes, sir.
Asila, you understood,
yes,
beta?
Sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that's all for today.